Hi, my name is Chaim Heber. I'm the founder of Cevro AI.
When was Cevro founded and what market problem did you aim to solve?
Cevro was founded about 2 years ago. Our goal is to make every player feel like a VIP. Doing that at scale is tremendously hard. You can't give that personalized feeling for every single player. So what we set out to do is provide AI agents that are uniquely skilled at providing support and interactions with every single player that feels genuinely personal and knows how to build a connection with every single player. And doing that, you're able to scale your sort of your VIP level experience to every single player.
How has Cevro grown over the years and what key milestones and achievements would you highlight?
Well, we actually started off as more of like a chat-focused solution, right? So that was primarily on like the chat widget that we were able to provide a level of support for the players. Since then, we've grown and we've brought on some many partners that are pushing us to continuously improve our services and add additional functionality. We're working with platforms like Everymetrics and some other of the big names. Now we're focusing more on proactive support. So we're doing reaching out to customers, we're doing voice, we're doing email. We've been able to achieve 85% automation rate, which is tremendously high. But more importantly, I think, is the fact that doing 85% automation is coming with a level of CSAT that is 4.5, which is really, really high.
Let's talk about your core product, the AI agent designed specifically for iGaming. Can you walk us through the integration process?
Sure. The integration process is actually very unique and really easy. We work with many of the platforms, existing platforms, making that a one-click integration. So you just click, add your API information, and we're able to then start the integration. We also have the ability to give the agents access to browsers, just like you would with a human agent. They're able to open up the browsers and click different buttons and do different actions, obviously with guardrails and permissions that are set by you guys.
What actions or tasks can the AI agent perform?
The sky is the limit. I know that sounds cliche, but because these agents are actually uniquely designed for the iGaming space, they have training to achieve actions like bonuses, granting bonuses, no deposit bonuses, welcome bonuses, KYC issues, deposit issues. They could actually go into the back office and resolve issues end to end.
In which cases or areas is it better to hand over to a human agent?
Well, there are many instances that you do want to escalate the chat to a human. For example, responsible gaming. Anytime that you see we see or detect an issue with responsible gaming, we escalate that immediately to the relevant department. I think there's also nuanced situations where you want to escalate the ticket to a human to have a second look or to have an opinion on the matter, where you don't want the AI agent to make a decision outside of an SOP.
Many people, both inside and outside the iGaming industry, still prefer speaking with a human rather than a chatbot. In your view, why is that, and how might your AI agent help change this perception?
Well, I think you're touching at the core of exactly why we have Cevro. Cevro was designed to build agents that feel human, that know how to build a connection with every single player. You're right, chatbots suck, and talking to chatbots is not something that players want to do. Our agents feel so genuine and so human that we see instances of players asking for the Instagram of the AI agents because it feels so real. That's how you're able to build a trust, a level of support where players actually prefer talking to these agents that are able to give them support right away over humans oftentimes.
And what are the main success metrics you focus on? I suppose it's not Instagram signups.
You suppose what?
It's not Instagram signups for your
team. That's correct. The primary metric is obviously the automation rate, right? Which is how many interactions are the agents covering by themselves without the need for human escalation. Additionally, which is more important, is what is the level of support that the agents are doing? What is the accuracy? We monitor every single conversation to see what is the CSAT and how well the agent is performing these tasks. This is the primary two metrics that we're looking at.
And do you have any success stories you could share with us?
Yeah, so we have many success stories. I have tons of conversations that I like to frame in my office. Primarily, there's one instance that's coming to mind, which is a player coming to an agent and saying, let's forget about my issue that I have. Thank you for resolving it, but let's just chat. And I think that once you're able to achieve that level of conversation with a player, you're able to do many, many things with them.
Since your AI agent handles sensitive personal information, how do you address data security and privacy concerns?
This is a very important question, especially for this industry. First of all, we're SOC 2 compliant. We take data security very, very, very seriously. Additionally, we block out all PII personal identifying information. We block that out before it goes to the model, and we encrypt all the information, all the data that is important.
Is your AI agent fully developed in-house, or do you rely on external AI models or services?
So we fine-tune many models. Every message that comes in runs through a data pipeline, a reasoning pipeline, to understand exactly what we need to do with that message, with that interaction. So we're mixing a few models. Some of them are public models, and some of them are the ones that we fine-tune in-house.
What does your roadmap look like for 2026?
Well, we have a very exciting roadmap ahead. Right now, we're focusing on our voice capabilities, which is coming soon, and we're focusing on the ability for the AI agents to be able to initiate a conversation at the right moments. So take, for example, if a player has a deposit issue, if a deposit has failed, we can, instead of waiting for the player to reach out reactively, we can proactively start a conversation and tell the player, hey, let me help you with this issue. Let me walk you through the deposit steps.
Finally, what message would you like to share with potential clients?
I think my main message would be for the operators to realize that there's two paths to take. Either to look at customer support as a cost center and something that you just have to do, or to realize that loyalty lies within customer support. If you do customer support in the correct way, in a personalized way, in a way that you're actually resolving issues quickly and effectively, players stay. Players want to stay and use this platform versus any other platform.
I agree. Thank you very much for the interview.
Thank you. Appreciate it.